everybody goes out and tries to win the gold, you know.
You win a silver, you're happy, you're content with what you accomplished, but you know, everybody here wants to win that gold.
But for the U.S. team, is anything but gold filled?
No, I mean, that's more so a question for y'all.
Yeah.
You know, we don't win gold, you guys are going to kill us.
Being at the Olympics this time compared to the last time for you, what's the difference? Time too.
I don't know if there's really a difference. It's the same type of emotions. It's just, you know, it's the same type of energy, and you know, the difference really is just the cities. But in terms of going to events and seeing athletes be great at what they do, I mean, that's the same.
I'm from San Diego, and I understand your dad played for the San Diego Clippers years ago. What would you want to say to folks in San Diego who have watched your career, and what's your connection to our fair city?
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for the support. You know, I went to school in La Jolla when I was a little baby.
Yeah.
So, I mean, yeah, that's San Diego's right in my backyard from Orange County, so.
Yeah, well, I covered the Padres for 15 years. We don't have an NBA team, but.
Got the Lakers.
Yeah, well, that's right. We're watching you, so. And finally, what's the difference of the fans here playing an Olympics game versus a professional game? There seems to be a difference as a spectator. How is it as a player?
Yeah, it's much more passionate, you know, because the country obviously means so much more. I mean, a brand and a company can mean a lot to a person, but when you're talking about your country, it has a certain level of significance that goes beyond that of a Lakers brand.
Thanks, Kobe.